For now, at least. Say, can you spare a minute?
Not really.
You know that weird black stuff coming out of the reactor? Well, the wind seems to be carrying it all the way over here. I'll admit my shack's never been in the best condition. But look at it. Holes everywhere. Holes so big that, would you believe it, all my chickens flew the coop. I plugged up the holes, but beyond that, I'm at wit's end here, let me tell you. Flapping and running around like crazy. How's an old woman like me supposed to catch them all? I can't keep up with a flock of chickens.
So we just need to catch your chickens, right?
Oh, thank you, dearie. They love the sound of this here clanger. Use it and they'll come out from wherever they're hiding and follow you right back to the coop.
My nose should serve us well here.
Right. Take it away.
Three of them are still in the village. We should start by searching the surrounding area. Got away. Back to square one.
happy, dearest.
I can't see who's live here. Red are those bugs? Betty, I'm not a real cat.
So what are you then?
I'm Kate Sith, fortune teller extraordinaire.
Think it might be time to top up the old batteries.
Do be careful. Toward the airfield. We must find her before the fiends do.
Pilots exactly.
Well, since the Republic's on the scrap, Shinra all but owns the skies.
Birds ought to count their blessings that Shinra hasn't come down on them yet.
Free flyers couldn't make care less though, and go wherever they please.
Good for them. Nobody owns the sky, least of all Shinra. Then our man gives him the finger as he flies by.
For real? Sounds like my kind of guy.
Long way back to town. Careful now.
Give it all you got.
Yeah.
No more playing. Any last words? Excellent care of them.
We should go too.
Most pleased to be reunited with you in this place they call home.
Thank you. They can be a handful, and chasing them really works up the appetite. So allow me to whip you up some of Grandma Kazra's famous grilled chicken. Say goodnight, Pippily.
Gotta eat.
From the top.
sent you here. I need your help to become a true warrior. Please, guide me to greatness. I'm Sotetsu, by the way, with the GYC. Captain's been singing your praises, you know. Telling everyone how you turned some state-of-the-art Shinra weaponry into scrap metal.
Oh, so you heard about all that? Well, I don't want to brag or anything, but we crushed him.
Really? You have to teach me how you did that. Gotta make Zack proud, you know? He's a friend of mine. We grew up together, hung out and stuff. Haven't heard from him since he left the village, though. But I'm sure a soldier like him's pretty busy. We may not be at war, but I bet they've got him traveling all over.
Sorry, no can do. We're just passing through.
Please! I'm begging you!
Wait. Me?
I knew as soon as I saw your throwing star. From the moment I laid eyes on you and your weapon, I just had to make you my teacher. Please, train me in your warrior ways.
Oh, I don't know. Well, since you're such a huge fan, one or two orbs might be enough compensation for my time. You sure you're up for the challenge?
Of course! I'll do anything!
Sweet music to my ears. Okay, new disciple, meet me over there when you're ready. For pain!
Don't worry. I am more than ready to receive your wisdom.
Hey!
Come along. See what you can learn, my second disciple. First and foremost, a ninja must have stamina. So let's see how much you've already got, shall we? After all, a ninja warrior must be able to make a tactical retreat back to her comrades when they need her.
Understood, Master.
Very well. Then with that, let our training begin. I hope you're staying focused, my young disciple. Fiend!
Please, teach me your ways, Master. Show me how it's done.
We got it.
fast and true.
Let's do this.
Get lost!
that's that.
Okay, let's keep up the pace.
This is only your first step on the long and winding road to ninjahood.
You've got more in you, because that ain't gonna cut it. Right, I'm gonna take a quick look around. You rest up for the next round.
Think you should focus on stamina, not strength.
Yeah, Zach told me the same thing. He used to train here all the time. Called it his secret gym. Of course, it wasn't much of a secret since everyone knew about it. But it sounded cool. Hard to live up to the legacy of a guy like that. Check this out. It was his favorite exercise. For strength. Body. And mind. Start. By training, you're behind.
Not like that. Gotta go deeper. Bend your knees more. Engage your glutes. And your quads.
Got it. Wherever he is, I hope he's doing good.
You cramping up?
Mayday! SOS!
What the?
Get back.
I got your number. second wind.
We actually won? Wow. All that training really paid off. Wait a sec. That's it. I've got an idea. See you back at the village.
Hello? What about my materia?
So, we just talked it over. And we'd like to ask you to train all of us in the art of combat. Our coalition's only as good as its weakest member, so it only makes sense to get stronger together.
We're really just passing through.
But you could rest here for a while.
Our services don't come cheap. It'll cost you 1,000,000 gil.
That's a pretty steep price, but we could probably manage.
What?
Oh, and he forgot to mention materia. Preferably the precious kind.
That we can't do.
Look, Sotetsu, they may be good at their jobs, but don't you think they're asking a bit much? We're looking for training, not trouble.
If you're looking for someone to train you, then look no further. No money or materia required.
Well, thanks, Cisne. That'd be great.
But what about them? They're veterans of the battlefield, and under their tutelage.
What? My tutelage not good enough? In case you've forgotten, I've seen my fair share of action. If all of you are serious about upping your game, I'll help you out. In fact, I've been meaning to offer for a while now. Seeing as we're here, well...
Sounds good to me.
Me too.
Well, I thought it was a good idea. Sorry I wasn't able to convince the rest of them. It's just, I felt something when we first met. Almost like fate. And I guess I got a little carried away.
Don't sweat it.
Then that settles it. Listen up. There's no backing out now, so be warned. I won't go easy.
Roger!
Wow, Yuffie! I know you've got to make a living and all, but you might want to consider lowering your rates.
I'll consider it after you consider paying me! Where's my materia? 3 orbs, or 2! Choose good!
Enough already. You're embarrassing yourself.
Just one, dude!
cooking happened. Watch your feet. What am I gonna do about you?
Wow, that's a smell.
We should go. Now.
Wait, don't leave. Treat you guys to a bowl if you help with the ingredients.
So, what more do you need?
Oh, right. Torgon's vegetables. That dog's probably parked near the village entrance, selling his produce. You mind swinging by and picking up some of his stuff for me?
What a sweet boy you are, staying behind for me.
You be good to Torgon now, you hear?
Did you just pay that dog money?
Oh, him? That's Melon, Torgon's pup.
He comes by from time to time to sell their farm's produce. We grow our own veggies here in town too, but the ones from Torgon's field are especially delicious.
Come on, let's go after him.
My boy, how'd it go today? Good?
Hello.
Not seen you before. Out of towners?
Just visiting, yeah. So, could we buy some of your produce?
Can't help you. Don't sell to out of towners. Barely got enough for the locals as is. Judging by them duds you got on, you're city folk, ain't you? I ain't about to sell the bounty of my soil to young'uns who ain't never got down in the muck with me and mine. Now get.
I don't know the first thing about farming, but I do know how happy these veggies are. Can practically hear 'em.
Got an eye for the stuff. But you're telling me you got an ear, too? What's this one saying?
Something about how rich the soil is. How it can thrive and spread its roots deep, grow big and strong.
I'll be. Oh, quit with the guilt tripping now, will ya? You know perfectly well I wasn't gonna leave them high and dry. We ain't seeing any more customers today, I reckon. So whatever we got left over is yours for the taking.
Thank you so much. We really appreciate it.
They finally learned to talk back?
We're actually trying to make Gungaga mushroom soup. What do you think we should use? Any advice would be great.
At the risk of stating the obvious, you'll need some quality Gungaga mushrooms. Or better yet, some Maganga mushrooms. They'll take that soup of yours to the next level. Things grow on a hill near here, but unless you got one hell of an eye, better to rely on a chocobo. They're flavorful suckers, so three calves ought to more than suffice. Pick them one at a time, though, if you want to keep your bird from getting all addled. Their aroma can be mighty powerful. And be mindful of the beasties, too. A lot of types are awful fond of the mushroom scent.
Gotcha.
Ah, and you can't forget the salt. Nothing brings out the flavor better than a sprinkling. And Magunga mushrooms being what they are, you're gonna want to savor it. Proper kind of salt for it's got a color close to this. Now then, you get them where they need to go.
Slightly different colors. Let's see. Well, one of these ought to match Torgon's picture. Yep, nailed it. I'd say that's the one we want. Like a waste to grind them up. All right, I think we've got plenty of salt now. Next up are the Magunga mushrooms. Morgan said we'll need a chocobo to sniff them out.
Must be the area Torgan was talking about. Though we're gonna need a chocobo to search.
Behold, the Magunga mushroom. Note its mushroom-like qualities. Just gotta be very careful. Thank you. perfectly plucked.
More of them might be around here somewhere. Okay, back to the birds. Another one. Into the sack it goes.
These things sure are fragile.
One more to go. Let's use the chocobos to find the last mushroom.
I won't give up.
a breather.
You're in good hands now. Do me proud.
Fight through it. No.
Or not, it all tastes the same, right? That should be it for the mushrooms. Yep, looks like we're done. Let's get this stuff to Cisne.
Notice the howling stop.
This is the final round of hurting
for
you.
What do you want from me? More heat? Got it? Falling far! Enjoy your new home in the trash can. Am I ever gonna get this right? We come bearing ingredients. Why don't you give it one more shot? I can pitch in too. Well, since you guys went to the trouble. Okay, one more shot. Whatever.
This might turn out okay.
Told you.
The Fairs are always inviting me over for dinner. Thought I'd be nice and return the favor by making them poison, apparently. But as you can see, I'm a sore loser.
Cooking's never as easy as you think.
Got that right. Didn't need to learn back in Midgar. The company provided all our meals. Tasted like garbage, though. Don't know how I stomached the stuff.
Not bad, huh?
But what about the bombberry flavor?
Bombberry? What, like the military rations?
Yeah, those. Sorry, that's really not important. What is important is the soup. The soup! Time to taste test!
Whoa there! Might want to let it cool.
Right. Oops. That's pretty good. And that salt you guys managed to find definitely brings it all together. It's crazy how a few changes made such a huge difference. Great job!
Stick to the paths, okay? Someone loves all the way out here. In this wee hut. Talk about rustic. Then again, I like it without Raffle. It's not without its charm, is it? In fact, this could be a whole new strength of the Shinra Resort to Bow.
After all that time and effort,
cast off modernity and embrace eternity.
Not make it. The hell with it. Back to square one. Huh? Who are you? Whatever, I don't have time to... That arm. That magnificent arm. It is a weapon. But how does it work? A universal adapter, allowing you to switch out weapons at will. But look at all these scratches. Wait, have you been going around punching things with your attachments?
Occasionally.
Doing so ought to have given you multiple bone fractures. But this unique cylinder provides unparalleled shock absorption, allowing for high-impact performance. Who was the genius that built this?
An old friend, I guess. Don't know where he's at now, though.
Wait right there! Eureka! Sorry, got carried away. My name's Izo. I've been trying to create the ultimate weapon, but my attempts have all failed miserably. But thanks to you, I finally made a breakthrough. I must harness the inspiration while I can. Please, help me build it. Gather the materials I need.
Well, if all you need is some materials, sure. Why not? Just leave it to us.
Wonderful. Thank you. I believe I left the map in my storage shed that you can use to find what I need. Grab that before you head out, and you shouldn't have any trouble.
Gotta say, I've never seen someone so interested in my arm. Most folks try their best to look the other way.
He's a weird one.
That's putting it mildly. Made me realize, too, how soft I've gotten. Because in the old days, I would have said no touching and decked his ass.
In the old days?
If it ain't the present, it's the past, son.
Izo was talking about. Don't know what else it'd be.
Well, let's see where it takes us. You ready?
Thank you.
now.
Let's see it.
That's the way to do it.
Close, I think. Let's take a look.
We got
up. Is that everything? It is. Let's head back and check in with Izo.
Thank you.
find everything? Excellent. It's all here. Thanks. If you're not in a rush, wait here while I finish up.
I get that it's your profession, but do you actually enjoy this, making weapons?
Of course I enjoy it. That's why I chose this job. Besides, it's the wielder who dictates the true value of a tool. Weapons, too. Aye, that's especially true for weapons. Yes, yes! I've done it! Feast your eyes on my masterpiece! My gift to you, I insist!
I may not be the gentlest owner, you know.
Use her as you like. The wielder dictates the value of the tool, remember? And by association, the value of the maker. Therefore, what good I put out into the world depends on who I entrust with my weapons. That's how I choose to see my part in it all.
Hell of a lot of pressure to put on some guy you just met, don't you think?
The adapter that your friend made. It's a gift in more ways than you know. He was thinking of your future, of what you might do after the dust settles. Today, you may have no choice but to wield a weapon. But tomorrow? Years from now? Think about it if you haven't. The man who fashioned your adapter is an inspiration in his own right. And that's no lie. Maybe one day you'll ask me to turn your arm into a giant egg beater. I'll make it so you can whip up a cake to serve 100.
Weird time to be joking around, man.
Not joking in the least. That's the price for my masterpiece. You owe me a cake fit for a king. So don't you go dying on me. You hear?
Yeah. Talk about a weirdo.
Friendly, though.
True. A weirdo with a heart of gold.
Do this fast. piece of cake. Let me finish this. So long.
Oh, it's over.
Now let's do this. Nothing to it.
Thank you. Good news, Cloud. I've unearthed information about a particularly rare monster. Deep in the forest lurks a fiend so foul... pardon me. So foul, the mere mention of it induces nausea. This noxious pest may be negatively impacting the biome. I suggest you expedite its removal.
Oh,